Okay, welcome to my channel. I have a ring light now and I'm super excited. So I thought, now that I have a ring light, which I just adjusted this whole frickin' thing so that it was gonna be in frame. This is gonna be super hard. Anyway, I thought now I can film at night. Why don't I film like a get ready with me or something? Okay. So, it absolutely drives me nuts when I see people like, you know, do that whole thing. I'm just going to put some like on my finger because I don't know what it is about things running down my face. That would freak me out. And, yeah. I don't think that I could handle that, yo. But if you're into that, you know, you do you. I'll do me over here. And just not have slime running down my face and whatnot. So, I'm pretty happy about having my ring light. Because since I started this newer job, I've been there about 6 months, I've just wanted to film at night because, like, I work nights, and when I get off, sometimes I have, like, this urge to just play with my makeup, and then I come in here and the lighting is terrible. I don't know, I just feel like I am always like restricted to doing daytime videos, which is 2 days a week that I was able to do that, and I didn't really have the time. Okay, so I'm going to use my favorite foundation right now, which is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation, and I'm just gonna like stick it on my beauty blender, which is how I usually do it. Check it out. I always need a little bit more around my chin. I feel like this shade is like slightly yellow on my skin tone. I don't know. Like right now, of course, I look super duper pale and white and whatnot, but in person, it just always looks a little yellow. I like to use the brush to blend out the like stampage, I guess. Also, I did change the position of my camera. See? Really hated like where I was sitting. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna do about that during the day because then there's gonna be like light coming in through the back. So not entirely sure what's gonna go on during the day. I have to just maybe rearrange my whole desk situation so that I can like have my camera facing the wall, maybe. I have no idea. For some reason, my concealer is just not wanting to like blend out, which usually doesn't happen, which is the NYX HD Concealer in Fair, which I really like. I think it's just getting kind of dried out. I'm almost out of it. So that might be it. Now my skin just looks dry. I guess because it is dry, but I don't like that. And then I'm just gonna like set my eyes, my under eyes, with this Kat Von D eyeshadow. Can't remember the name. It's on the back, but I don't know if this is like in the right order, if that makes sense, because like sometimes I don't know. But this eyeshadow is like perfect for setting my under eyes. So that's what I do. So I've been meaning to play with this palette, this Winky Luxe Kitten palette, because it's like super cute, but I just haven't because I'm a turd. I played with this one, the shade right here. I think a cat just made a mess. Anyway, as I was saying, I've played with Nine Lives. I put it over a black eyeshadow, it was really pretty. And I want to play with it again, but I don't know. We'll see how this goes. I'll prime my eyes with my Essence I Heart Color Intensifying Primer. For this part, I will zoom in just a tad, like the tiniest bit. Okay. Because I don't want to like zoom in too much because then I'll go out of focus. And that's annoying. Okay, so I'm going to try not to cover my face with my stupid mirror like this. So, I'm gonna take the lightest shade, which is Duchess, and I'm going to just put it all over my lid as the transition shade. Same brush I'm gonna take Purr, which is this little nudie pink shade, And I'm just going to go over that, just kind of build up the color a little bit. It's a little bit shimmery, but that's okay. It's fine. Satiny color. I don't really know if you can like see it. You could really tell my eyebrows need to be plucked. But anyway, pause for just a second. I think I know why my cats are being turds. So I'm just gonna wipe off this brush and keep using it because why not? I'll go back to my face later. I don't know why I did that. I just kind of went out of order. But I'm gonna use this color, which is Cheshire. And I'm gonna start smoking it out with this color because it's gorgeous. I'm gonna take this brush. These are Wet n Wild brushes, by the way. Just realized I wasn't using these like on purpose or anything, but these are good brushes. Don't really know what this one is, but I'm gonna just take a little bit of this and like put it on my lower lash line. Take holographic, I believe this is. I don't know why this is hard for me to figure out. Okay, strut over here. So yes, holographic. Which is coming off really strange looking on camera. And I'm gonna try putting this over top of the red and seeing what happens. Those shadows are like a different texture almost. The holographic one and the cat eye one. It's like brushes just don't do anything to them almost. I put 9 lives in the middle. That's what I just did. Because I wanted to see what would happen. I wanted originally to do like a dark look. And now that I know my finger will work better with them, that's what I'm doing. And I'm just gonna take the tiniest bit of holographic, like along the edges. does get really messy when you're doing that, so watch out. But now, just to clean that up, I'm gonna go in with the first shade, the transition shade Duchess, and just kind of clean up that lower lash line a tad. Whoa. I got a little bit do up my face some more. I'm gonna use this blush. Well, first I'm gonna like set my face with my e.l.f. powder, duh. Which I usually do right after I do my concealer and foundation, but for some reason I did everything like way backwards. Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in Party. Party. Okay, it looks like I have like way more blush than I actually do. Tone it down just a little bit. On camera, I just look like a freaking clown right now. So I'm like white and like pink cheeks and weird eyes right now at the moment. The color or shade Lazarus as my contour because it works pretty dang well for a nice cool tone contour for a pale person like me. I am a little bit of contour. Now let's go back to the eyes. I'll zoom back in. Whoa. So that's probably good enough, I would say. This really dense eyeshadow brush by Flower that I got at Walmart. I think it was like a $7 brush, which is kind of crazy, but I just really wanted it for some reason. And it was not everything that I hoped it would be, but it's a good brush. And I'm gonna use Duchess, which is that first shade I used, and I'm just gonna use that as my highlighter shade and kind of blend out the edges. I wonder if this blue eyeliner would look good with this. Doing it. Yay, blue eyeliner. So you can't really like tell that it's like blue, but if you're looking, you know. Now pretty sure that's all I'm gonna do besides mascara. I'm gonna use the Pure Fully Charged Mascara powered by magnetic technology. I think I used this the other day. It was either this one or a different one, but I don't know that I liked it. Okay, so maybe I didn't use this one. Maybe I used a different one. But it's not bad. It's kind of sticky. Like when you're applying it. I kind of noticed that I have it on. Is today the day I wear this? Nope. It is not the day. I'm just gonna put on this Sephora lip gloss, maybe, because it smells like coffee. My lips are very dry. I forgot to zoom out. Here we go. I'm zoomed out. Okay, so not wearing a lip liner or anything like that, but here I am. Wearing my Sephora lip gloss and my Get Ready With Me a look. I hope you enjoyed the video. There were many interruptions, but I had fun. And if you like watching these types of videos of me doing these things with my new ring light, then don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you.